Hello, my name's Ian. Welcome back to the Grow Zone. I'm here at the shipping container and I'm building a mushroom farm. I won a few more auctions. A few things have been delivered. Stainless steel table from home that I'm going to fit in here just for placement. I need to test a few things today to see if they work. I need to unbox a few things, so wait for that. Should make things misty in here. And yeah, I have a few more ideas for power, which I'd like to show you guys. I've got some crude photos that I took. Hopefully you can give me some advice if it's going to work, if it's a good idea. And I need to think about running water as well at some point. First, let's start with this. These are beauties behind me. Fridges. I won this auction a little bit after I filmed the last video, actually. I've got one photo of them on the trailer, I think, which I'll insert here. And I am yet to plug them in. So they've been standing for almost a week now. So they should be settled. They're industrial fridges, as you can see. This one is wide, 71 to be exact. This one's a little skinnier, 58. I'm not sure if I'm going to need both of them directly, but it's good to have both of them. But the true test is going to be to plug them in. Run the power leads down the bottom there. And I have my little adapter. I'll find some power from the farm here. We can turn these things on. Right, so here's the first one. And they are, oh, hello. They are epic in here. Fully stainless steel. These little brackets slot in the end there. And then just clip on. Nice and easy. And I've got three shelves here for this big one. Unfortunately, the other one didn't come with shelves. That's okay, I can work out a solution. See the big file at the top there. Have another look in here. Not as shiny as the Zanussi. Still a good size. Much, much narrower inside. Again, with this same shelving system that one clipped in the back and then clips on. Very similar design, actually. Big fan at the top there. And lots to be explored as the thermostat, I suppose. This one isn't as dirty. Needs a bit of a wipe, it's a bit greasy. Seal at the bottom there's a bit broken. It does seem to shut properly though. Oh yeah, really happy with these. Okay, let's get some power sorted and we'll plug them in, see if they turn on. So I'm gonna do the Electrolux first. I'll plug it in. This is genuinely the first time I've done this. I bought them in a building that didn't have any power, so they couldn't test them for me or verify they worked. So there you go. I've got to turn it on at the top. Okay. Oh, that's good. Good noise. Okay, I don't know what that does. Let's just leave it for now. Good noises though. This is the Zanussi. There we go, it's come to life. Good noises. I do not know what these control panels do. I need to investigate that. Naughty cold. And we have an ice man. No. It's rubbed off. Ellie well. This one, the Electrolux says 16. Zanussi says zeros. Good noises from these two. I'm pleased so far. Oh yeah. I'm just going to leave these two running now and carry on with the video, and we'll come back and open the doors and see if they're cold a little bit later. So as I mentioned earlier, I have these tables. I have three of these. These are stainless steel, custom built for a friend of mine, and they're 165 long, I think. We'll have to double check that. And this is the frame for them. I'm just going to put this in onto the right hand side here of the container, just to get an idea of the size of the partition I need to create, and see what a working space feels like in there. Okay, very cool. once again, the corrugated floor is proving difficult for everything that has caster wheels on. They either fit perfectly in the lines or fall between the gaps. So this is a great size. Oh, fridge did something. Great size table. I have three of these stainless steel tops. Now this is one of the best frames. Been fully painted and welded. Should be good. This is going to be a good operating space. I'm now quite aware that I've very much narrowed my working space in between here. Maybe this is going to be annoying. Any ideas, comments are welcome. I could have this table a little bit closer here. Now I put the top on. Again, at the mercy of the corrugation. This is a great size. This is a meter. A 3 meter partition takes me to here. From the door. It seems like a lot of space, but with the tables and the fridges, and I'm gonna put a few more items in here before I'm ready to harvest. I think it could be the way to go. Let me know what you think, please. If you haven't already, please consider liking this video and subscribing to the channel. I've added a playlist of these videos as well for you to check out in order. And yeah, continue on the journey with me as I build a mushroom farm here in southern Sweden. But the partition wall is quite important. I've recently seen a video of a guy doing custom mushroom farm builds. He builds up the containers and then sells them for a company. And he had this great idea. I took a quick screenshot of a short that I watched from him on YouTube. I'll link it down in the description. What he decided to do with his partition was to frame out the wall and have a double glass door with a sliding, one of the doors sliding in here. Yeah, let me know what you guys think. Have you tried that? Is it a good idea? Is it going to seal properly? I think it'll go sort of, it'll start about here and then go straight across here somewhere, giving us a really nice rooting chamber further back. And also we can see everything. I think it could be nice. I'm just going to take you on a little journey outside the container. Took a photo of a shipping container that had quite an interesting three-phase in, two actually, but the three-phase were mounted here and here, and then the plugs were facing down so they didn't collect water, and then the wires came in and under the container and then up, I assume, up through the floor. I didn't go in the container. I'll put a photo in here now of what I saw. I think it could be quite a good idea. Let me get around to the other side of the container while you're looking at the photo. See if we can see a good access point. So the sill of my container is a lot deeper, although I assume it goes to the floor. Yeah, if we aim for the power to come in here somewhere, and then there could be a junction box on the wall here somewhere. And the fridges aren't in their final place by any means. They've got plenty of room to go to the left. Little space here, although that is quite useful for stacking crates or maybe a shelving unit in there. We'll see. All to be worked out. Thank you if you made it this far. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. You waited for whatever's in this box. I'm sure you've guessed by now that this is a humidifier. It's actually, as is often the way with an online purchase, a bit smaller than I thought it was. But here we go. Oh yeah, what was in there? I think there's more caster wheels. Oh, those are smart. Nice grippy rubber casters. And this is some kind of shut-off valve. And some nuts and bolts. Oh yeah, look. And you can see the, what are they called? Atomizers? Down at the bottom there. So that's a serious unit. And so in the box, there was the unit there. And I had this braided flexi pipe Again, I need to get the dimensions of that.
Okay.
Oh, here we go.
Ooh.
Nice. There's the fan. And this is... look, hey, this would go in here when you're ready to make it operational. And this is humidity, I suppose. The casing seems to come off. I do have both halves of it. Moving around the other side, we have, and they're clearly marked, great. So switch, manual at the top, stop in the middle, automatic on the bottom. And there's the pin for the humidity sensor. And here's the water inlet, overflow, and drainage. I need to work out all these. Any plumbers out there? Please give me a shout. This should produce enough humidity for 120 square meters, but there's only one way to find out, and that's to get it all set up. So I'm gonna strive to do that. I haven't got any screwdrivers or tools with me today. Even go on a shelf this side, perhaps, and be mounted up here and come in and up and then through into the fruiting room here, and then maybe I run a pipe along the center or even the side here, producing mist all the way along. Let's put our head inside a fridge, see if it's cold. Oh yes, oh yes. A nice little light there too. And the fan stops when you open. It's also a good feature. Oh yeah, nice and cold in there. This is fantastic news. These were a great deal. If you haven't seen the last video, please check it out here. I'll put a link and one in the description as well. Like and subscribe if you haven't already, and continue as I continue on this journey building a mushroom farm. We're getting there. Okay, bye.